The unknown is gripping people here in the upstate. One family is among 900 nationwide trying to adopt a child from Haiti. News 4's Mike McCormick picks up the story from our Spartanburg newsroom. Mike, what's the family found out so far?
Well, Carol, thanks to an update on Twitter this morning, they do know that their little boy is okay. What they don't know is how much longer it's going to take to bring him home.
We have Kim and I and two little girls.
But the Rhodes family isn't complete yet.
We feel like he's missing.
He is Frankie.
In some ways, Frankie and I look nothing alike, but we always get people who tell us you guys look exactly alike. And so I take that as a compliment because he's the most beautiful kid that you could really ever imagine. He's got joy in his eyes.
After a high school mission trip to Haiti changed her life, Kim Rhodes wanted to adopt from there.
I would be on a plane tomorrow to get him if I could.
They're 2 years into the adoption process, which included trips to Port-au-Prince to see him.
Go get daddy.
On Tuesday, everything came into question.
The first thing you want to know is, did they survive the earthquake? But surviving the aftermath might be just as difficult.
Frankie is believed to be in this picture of children who now have to sleep outside.
As a mom, it's just really hard not being the one that's there, making sure he's okay.
The other worry is if it'll be even harder to get the two-year-old home.
Right now, all the government buildings that housed all of our paperwork and in the process, they have been destroyed.
A family waiting to be whole.
Our girls talk about him like he's already here.
And the Rhodes say they have already heard of rumors about potential temporary visas being issued to those children who are already in the adoption process. Now, to learn how the Rhodes family is trying to raise awareness about adoption or just to follow their progress, you can go to the Scene on 4 section of our website. That's WYFF4.com. Mike McCormick, WYFF News 4, live tonight in the Spartanburg newsroom.